An essential part of the development process for the construction of new businesses and homes on the Akwesasne territory is ensuring that SRMT business and building codes are followed. Codes, which were formed on the foundation of decades of construction knowledge and experience, are updated every 3 years to incorporate new information. SRMT Director of Compliance Elliot Lazor talks about the absolute importance of building codes in the community.
The codes will help the community benefit by making it a safer home, a better designed home, more efficient home, having proper fire routes or fire exits, having the proper fire alarms. So those are some of the things that we're looking at when we're going into homes now, new construction predominantly, and most of them are derived from incidents that had casualties or loss of life, and they, after the investigation, they came back and defined what could have been done to prevent those incidents.
With the construction of the Mohawk Casino in 2008 came the implementation of rules and regulations for new facilities. At that time, SRMT compliance began the process to have certified code inspectors available for any new construction projects.
I have three full-time compliance staff that are New York State code certified. We are the assigned inspector for any of the loan programs through the Akwesasne Housing Authority. We review their plan, we review their foundation to make sure that it's proper, whether it's commercial buildings or homeowners. So you're getting a more fair project overall in the end.
Part of the evaluation will include configuration for the proper egress or the direct route to exit a building during a fire. This is a key focus during the inspection process for homes and businesses.
When it becomes a public building, then we will absolutely have to look at the fire routes, the fire safety. What do they have for a sprinkler system? Are they sprinklered? Are they required to be sprinklered? Or do they have proper exit signs? Do they have proper emergency lighting? Do they have proper occupancy? How many people can be in that room and safely exit that room? Do they have proper evacuation plans? Are they able to leave a room in the back safely without obstruction? Are the hallways clear? Are the doorways in the right? Do they swing the right way to make the egress without any issues?
The need for economic development is essential for the growth of the community. But when a new structure is erected, the analysis of related impacts on the environment is just as important. Director of the SRMT Environment Division, Tony David, speaks about the process and importance of following environmental assessment guidelines.
Basically, we're looking at any impacts that may result from the development of the site that could cause undue harm to tribal natural resources. So this could be impacts to wetlands, it could be pollution that might migrate off the site, and also we're looking for any impacts that may happen to tribal waters. An applicant can start the environmental review process by downloading the application from the tribe's website. And then if you need assistance with that, you can contact the environmental coordinator here who will guide the applicant through the process. And it's really helpful if you come prepared with any site maps of any sort of any structures that are going to be constructed or any features like parking areas or stormwater systems that will be needed as part of the construction of the site. It requires a public comment period, and that gives an opportunity for the public to voice any concerns that they have about the construction of the project. Once the process is complete, the Environment Division would issue a finding of no significant impact. So basically that's just gives them authorization to begin.
Currently there are no penalties for not adhering to building codes, but this could change in the future.
One of the new key things is we have tribal council support of if they're a new location, whether it's a business or if it's a private dwelling, and they don't participate 100% in our new process, they may not get connected to have electrical service. They may not get connected to the water service. It's not that we want to impede any business. We want to make it so that you're all comfortable and safe.
I think as Akwesasne Lono, we all have a responsibility to protect our tribal natural resources. Nobody else is going to do this for us. And so as we look at economic development opportunities, the environmental assessment process is one way to foster and encourage economic growth, but also to minimize the harm and detriment to our tribal natural resources.
Tribal codes are implemented throughout the application process. To learn more about code requirements and for any questions before construction starts, contact the tribe's compliance department at 518-358-2273. For environment assessment questions, call the Environment Division at 518-358-5937.